So, hello everyone. I'd like to start by saying thanks to Mr. Foley and to everyone here for having me here today. My name is Molly. I'm a primary student at Southend High School for Boys. I finished in 2012. After school, I went to the University of Surrey and studied mechanical engineering for 4 years. The last time I was here, just over 2 years ago, I finished as well by saying I'm now a graduate, looking for a grad job. And I'm very proud to say that I'm now working at McLaren Automotive as a design engineer. I'm not a public speaker, I'm an expert in what I'm talking to you about today. I'm purely here to share my experiences and my struggles over the last few years in the hope that what I have to say may make it easier for some of you if you find yourself in a similar situation. So from when I was a similar age to you guys now, I have had periods of struggling with social anxiety that at times have brought me to complete rock bottom. Today I'm going to talk to you through the events that kicked off and how over the next couple of years my anxiety snowballed until it brought me to a complete breaking point. In the years since that time, I've been able to build myself back up to being a capable and confident person. But looking back on this journey, I realised how much easier it could have been. For the first few years, I suffered complete silence and I had no idea what was actually happening to me. Reaching out and getting the right help was what started my recovery. My hope is that if any of you find yourself in a similar struggle with mental health, you will avoid making the same mistakes I did. I'm going to begin with a story that may seem strange, but it's a memory which is a very clear milestone when my issues began. About 7 or 8 years ago, I was in love with a girl, and I was at my house with my girlfriend at the time, and we were cuddled up on the sofa. We started talking, but I was feeling irritable and nauseous. I assumed that I must be unwell, so I dived into the bathroom. However, when I got to the toilet, something felt fine again. I wasn't sure why, but I assumed that I must have just had a funny symptom, so I went back to the room in the hope that I'd be okay. Once I got back on the sofa and started talking again, I had the same sensation. So I ran onto the toilet again, and this time I was sick. I went back and we decided to go to sleep and hope that it would be better in the morning. I lay in bed feeling terrible, still feeling very sick, but horribly aware that whatever was happening to me had nothing to do with being physically unwell. I had no idea at the time it was actually caused by anxiety, and it was the first step in what would be a long struggle with anxiety. It's very difficult to try and explain what suffering with anxiety issues is actually like. Anxiety is an emotion we all know. We feel it when we're in stressful or affecting situations, and it's part of being a healthy human being. You would associate it with feelings like stress, or nervousness, fear, and dread. However, feeling anxious is not just a mental response. There's also a list of physical changes that happen to our body when you feel anxious. You kick off a fight or flight response to prepare yourself to deal with whatever threat you're facing. Your heart starts to pump much faster to feed your muscles and blood as you run away from parts of your body that is not needed. You start to shake and sweat, and your chest starts to feel tight as all the muscles in your body tense up. When you have issues with anxiety, it's like there's a problem in the circuit somewhere that keeps on causing that response to be kicked off and there isn't justification. And it's not a nice feeling at all. So back to me and my girlfriend. So this was new to me, and I probably felt a bit of pressure and anxiety in this situation. My anxious response kicked off and stopped digestive processes in my body. Blood flow to my stomach reduced and caused the muscles to relax. This made me feel nauseous. The prospect of me sick in that situation and the other feelings probably made me more anxious, and the process began to slow. As mentioned, I ended up being sick. And this all makes perfect sense to me now, and I can rationalise it easily. But at the time, all I knew was that I was a 16-year-old boy that just threw up because I got too close to my girlfriend. There's a one-off situation, and this is bad enough. Then it happened the next time I was with her, and then the next time I was with her. My anxiety was always focused around feeling nauseous, and very often making me sick. Up until this point, I was a normal and confident person. I never would agree that I would suffer with a mental health issue, and it wasn't even something in the bottom line. It started happening in other situations as well, at parties or social events, even just eating around people. Each time it happened in a new situation, would widen the area of my life that would cast a shadow over. If it happened in a new scenario, I'd expect it to happen again. If I had a bad anxious reaction, it would often have affected me for the next few days or weeks, where I'd feel anxious in general and be expecting other bad reactions. Over the next couple of years, whilst I was still at school and living at home, it was manageable. I still had no idea really what was happening to me, but situations where I'd be affected were relatively few and far between. I'd go through bad periods I'd struggle, and times I'd be relatively anxiety free. However, when I left home for university, I started to really struggle. So university is great, but it's also really tough, and it's important to be prepared for that. Now, I couldn't wait to get to university. The thought of living away from home was so exciting, and I was really looking forward to making new friends and setting up a new life as an adult. I had a big expectation and pressure on myself for everything to be amazing. But the massive set of changes hitting me at once caused my anxiety to affect me in almost every aspect of my life. I went to my first university meet and greet and I had an anxiety attack and had to leave. The same happened at my first lecture. I got all my housemates on campus very well, but it started happening around then too. I remember one of my housemates made a meal for the whole house and had to pretend that I was ill because I knew I wouldn't be able to sit down and eat it with them. It got to a point where I couldn't even really leave my room without struggling with anxiety, so I just stayed in there all day, every day. All this time I still had no idea really what was happening to me. I thought I was either some sort of socially inept weirdo or that I was going completely insane. It got to a point where basically no longer functioned. See a way the situation getting better. I thought I was the only person this had ever happened to. I thought that no one would understand if I was, what was going on if I tried to explain it, and that even if I could, they wouldn't be able to offer me any useful advice. I reached complete rock bottom and went home for the weekend, where for the first time I tried to explain what was happening to me, which was to my mum. You know, my mum had always been very close, and on top of that, she's actually a psychotherapist. Yeah, it was so difficult for me to try and comprehend and explain what was happening to me that it took me that long to try and speak to her about it. Within about a 2-minute conversation, she told me that I'd been having anxiety issues. She also told me that it's the most common reason that people get counselling, and that across the population, especially in universities, people suffer with mental health issues like anxiety, stress and depression all the time. In that 2-minute conversation, I made more sense of what was going on to me than I had done in the last 2 years of trying to work out on my own. Before I knew it was anxiety, there was this big, dark, faceless problem. And I had no idea how much bigger or dark it was going to get. Not only was it something that loads of people suffered with, it was now something that lots of people had got better from. And knowing this was a huge help for me to start to get on top of the problem. It was by no means a quick fix. Since then, I've made many small steps of improvement that slowly built me up to get me to the point where I am now. The biggest thing which helped me improve in time was increasing my knowledge and understanding of the situation. I went to counselling and I gave lots of information about anxiety and the effect it has on people. Once I started to learn about what actually happens in the body when you're anxious, I could relate to all of the issues that I've been having and start to make sense of it. Once you know what the problem is, you start to put things into place to deal with it. I spoke to people about my anxiety issues more openly and actually found that far from people thinking I was a socially inept weirdo, people were always empathetic and many of that had similar experiences. This leads me to the second biggest thing that helped me improve. I stopped beating myself up about it. I used to think so bad of myself for being an anxious person, though it made me weak and a bit pathetic. But I now realise how wrong this was. I have anxious tendencies, and I'll never completely get rid of them. But this doesn't make me any less of a person. Anyone dealing with mental health issues needs to know and really believe this. The third is an ongoing journey to build myself up through my experiences and successes. I said before that bad experiences would leave me feeling susceptible or vulnerable to it for a long time. This is true, and it's the same in reverse, every round. Doing a talk about this is probably the best example of a time where my anxiety would previously cause me huge issues. that I can now look back at the challenges that I overcame and know that I can get through them. The fact that you're sitting in this room as a member of this school is testament that each of you has huge potential. You have an exciting and challenging few years ahead of you. Don't expect it to be easy, but know that you can overcome whatever is thrown at you. If you find yourself struggling, then don't suffer in silence. Reach out and get the help you need to get back on track. Taking responsibility for yourself and striving to achieve your potential gives you huge amounts of meaning and satisfaction. Facing challenges head on will make you grow and develop, and I implore you all to do the same. Because of what has happened to me, there was a time when I didn't think I was going to be able to stay at university or ever get a decent job. After getting the help I needed, I stayed at university, actually knuckled down, got a first class degree, and I now work as an engineer at one of the most prestigious engineering companies in the country. To finish off, I'd like to say thank you again for having me here today. 2 years ago, when I did this talk, it felt like the final step in my journey to overcome my anxiety issues. I hope that if any find yourself struggling like I did, that after today, you won't be in the same state.